see here. Let me see if we are live. It says here we do not have. Oh, there we go. Outstanding, outstanding. We are beginning to transmit live. Hang on. There's nobody watching yet. Nobody watching yet. The live transmission is on its way, I guess. Okay. Very good. Very good. Today, students, today we have another Isaac's English YouTube class. This is a real English class. Una clase de inglés real, lo más real que la podemos hacer en YouTube. And today's class, we're going to talk about who, what, which. We're not going to, it's not that we're going to talk about it. We're going to make questions with who, what, which. Vamos a formular preguntas con who, what, and which. Now, my name is Isaac Osorio. Me llamo Isaac Osorio. And today, I'm going to be your English teacher. And to participate in this class, para que participen en esta clase, les recomiendo que vayan a la descripción, bajen el archivo para que escriban junto conmigo, okay? Para que escriban junto conmigo, que participen junto conmigo. Oh, outstanding. But first, let's go. There we go. We have some people now. We have some people watching. 16. And here we go. So, I'd like to thank, quiero agradecer, Emily Martinez. Dice, quiero hablar inglés, me gustaría aprender. Well, watch the videos and start studying English. Emily, thank you for commenting. Dayelin Vázquez, muchas gracias por su video. Vivo en Estados Unidos, pero no tengo con quién hablar. Donde vivo, se habla mucho en español. Dayelin, tienes que buscar a otra persona que quiera aprender inglés y tienen que hacer un trato, un pacto de siempre hablar inglés entre ustedes mismos. Yo siempre les recomiendo eso, ¿ok? Hagan un pacto. La otra persona en serio tiene que desear aprender inglés igual que tú. Si no, no funciona. Eli Saúl José García Lara dice... estaba hablando de cómo interpretar en contexto. Para escuchar inglés no debes de intentar entender todas las palabras, sino de intentar entender la idea general de lo que se habla y de ahí formular tu interpretación, porque es lo que hacen los anglófonos. Ellos no escuchan cada palabra, ellos no esperan que cada palabra se pronuncie bien. Okay. Entonces, ¿qué es lo que tienes que hacer? Tienes que aprender a hablar y pronunciar bien, y esto es muy repetitivo en mí, los verbos, los adjetivos. Los verbos son las acciones, los adjetivos son las cosas, personas, lugares, y los adverbios, las palabras que describen a las acciones, los adjetivos, las palabras que describen a las cosas, personas, lugares. Y el día de hoy, la clase, vamos a continuar con los adjetivos, que son las palabras que describen a las personas, las cosas, pero cómo preguntar acerca de personas, cosas, ¿no? Ok. Azul Violeta, thank you, dice Dauri Gomer, thank you. Juan Carlos Rodríguez, thank you also. Maritza Inoa, thank you very much. La Barbie Torres, thank you for your comment. Alejandro López, dice Alejandro López, ¿quién me puede decir qué significa view deal? View deal, a lo mejor cuando tú estás viendo una página donde venden artículos, dice view deal. Es deal significa trato o oferta. View es ver. Entonces, ve la oferta. The first girl was so cute. Okay, es un comentario acerca de un video. Thank you for commenting. Kyla Rose, Javier Peñalosa. Tigo Música. Cinco Tigo. Okay, muy bien. And Wildermar Sandoval, thank you for commenting on the class. De nuevo, les comento que vean el video, vean la clase y después regresen a la clase un día, dos días después, vuelvan a ver. Intenten trabajar con el archivo que les pongo abajo en la descripción. So, observe carefully. Vamos a dar un pequeño repaso. No lo voy a escribir para no tardar tanto, ¿ok? Pero ustedes lo pueden escribir si no vean la clase anterior y allí está, allí escribí el significado de lo que estas palabras significan. Estas palabras son adjetivos. Son palabras que describen personas o cosas. ¿Ok? Tall, alto. Short, corto o bajo. Long, largo. Largo de medida, largo. Largo de distancia, no largo de lárgate, ¿ok? So long, porque ya lárgate es un verbo. High, high, alto o elevado. High es alto o elevado. Low, bajo. Wide, ancho. Narrow, narrow significa angosto. Big, grande. Small, pequeño, chico. Young, young, joven. Old, viejo. Fat, gordo. Thin, delgado. Nice, agradable. Unpleasant, desagradable. Pleasant, agradable. Es otra palabra para agradable. Pretty, pretty, bonito o bonita. Pretty. Ugly, 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 feo. Round, round, redondo. Okay. Square, cuadrado. Dark, oscuro. Light, claro o ligero. Algo ligero o algo claro es light. Dirty, dirty, sucio. Clean, limpio. Shiny, shiny, brilloso. Dull, opaco. Smart, inteligente. Dumb, no inteligente. Okay, hablamos de cómo describir a personas por su hair, cabello. Gray, gris, gris o canucio. Blonde, rubio, rubia. Brown, es cabello café. Red, rojo. Black, negro. Bald, bald significa no tener pelo, estar calvo. Okay, I'm bald but from behind. Okay, no me pueden ver, pero acá atrás. Bald. Straight, straight es lacio, lacio. Cuando se refiere a cabello es cabello lacio, se dice straight hair. Wavy, ondulado. Wavy, ondulado. Curly, son rizos. Okay. Skin, cuando hablamos de piel, you're black, brown o white. Black, negro. Brown es las personas morenas. White, blancas. Eyes, eyes, nos referimos a dark, que es oscuro, o a hazel, que es claro. Cuando hablamos de ojos claros, se dice hazel, hazel, ok. So, black, negro. Brown, café, café. Y si están muy claros, dices hazel brown. Green, verde. Blue, azul. Very well, very well, excellent. Eso fue el repaso, un pequeño repaso de palabras, de vocabulario que aprendimos en la clase anterior. Okay, excellent, excellent. Today, we're going to make questions. El día de hoy quiero que hagan preguntas. Okay, y van a hacer preguntas junto conmigo. Okay, por ejemplo, vamos a hacer preguntas con what y con which. Which. Okay. Who se refiere a quién. Quién. What, qué, which, cuál o qué también. Very well. Now, let me see who has said hello in the class. ¿Quién ha dicho hello en la clase? Okay. We have 20 viewers. 20. 20 viewers. ¿Y quiénes? Ah, we have hi. Bueno, I can't read these characters, but whoever you are, hi. Dowdy Gamer, hi. Irene Gardinia Carrera. Dice René Gardinia Carrera Andrade. Hello, how are you doing? Josephine Zamor, hi. Sandra Montoya, hi. Emily Florian. Dice, siento que es difícil. No, no es difícil, Emily. Okay? Es fácil. Es fácil. Y recuerden que la mejor forma de aprender es cometiendo errores. The best way to learn is when you make mistakes. If you make mistakes, you will learn. Okay? Sergio Comiso. He dice, yo soy de Argentina. Hello, hello, Sergio Comiso. Okay? Excellent. Outstanding, outstanding. Let's go back to our class. Oops. Sorry. Let's go back to our class here. Okay, so in this picture, what do we see? We see a bridge. Okay? In the picture, there is a narrow bridge. A narrow bridge, okay? In this picture, we see a wide bridge. Okay? And this one, I'm going to take it out. Okay? All right, so I'm going to say who. There's no person, no hay persona. Entonces no puedo hacer la pregunta con who. Okay, but tenemos dos puentes, two bridges. So which cuál is a long bridge? Which is a long bridge, okay? Which is a long bridge? Okay. This is bridge one, and this one's bridge two. Okay. Can you see here? I'm going to try to put a number one here. But I can't. Okay, one. No. Okay. Sorry about that. Okay. This is bridge one. One. Okay. And this one, así es como lo vamos a hacer. And this one is bridge two. One and two. Okay. There we go. One and two. Okay, which is a long bridge? Which is a long bridge? Which is a long bridge? One or two? Which is a short bridge? It's a short. Which is a short bridge? Which is a short bridge? So answer in the comment box, which is a long bridge? Bridge one or bridge two? Okay. Which is a... Okay. What bridge? What bridge? What bridge is narrow? What bridge is narrow? Okay. No, I don't like that question. I'm going to leave it with these two questions. So which is a long bridge? Okay, bridge. Number is a long bridge. Okay, it's a long bridge. Let's see, what do you guys say? Solo dime Matías. Ah, ok, Matías. Bueno, me confundiste con los caracteres orientales que no... No me animé a porque no los conozco. Si son japoneses, coreanos, chinos. Por eso nada más dije caracteres. Ok, so, which is a long bridge here? A long bridge, a long bridge. Which is a long bridge? Ok, a long bridge. Which is a long bridge? Long. Long dijimos que era largo. ¿Cuál es el que es largo? Este no lo podemos ver en su totalidad, pero este debe ser más largo. So bridge number two is... Bridge number two is a long bridge. Which is a short bridge? Well, that leaves no other option. Okay. Bridge... Number one is a short bridge. Bridge number one is a short bridge, okay? Bridge number one is a short bridge. Es el corto. El número uno es el más corto. Very well. Now, I need you to participate. Necesito que participes. We have a picture, okay? We have two pictures. They are people, persons, girls, right? Girls. Girls. Now. What girl? Okay. What girl has long hair? What girl has long hair? What girl? What, recuerden que es que, y podemos formular también preguntas con qué, ¿no? Entonces, what girl, qué muchacha, tiene cabello largo. Okay. Podemos formular la pregunta así también, ¿no? O podemos formularla así: which girl has long hair? Which girl has long hair? So, what girl has long hair? Okay, girl number one. Okay, or girl number two. Or girl number two. Okay. Girl number one or girl number two. What girl has long hair? Number one. She has long hair. Number two, she has long hair or short hair. She has long hair. Girl number two has long hair. Girl number one has long hair. Okay? Las dos tienen el pelo largo. So, entonces, ¿cómo vamos a responder cuando ambos o ambas? Ambas tienen pelo largo. Para decir ambos, okay, we say both. Both. Okay. Noten esta palabra, both. Both girls have long hair. Both girls have long hair. Ambas. Okay? So, which girl is pretty? Which girl is pretty? Which girl is pretty? Is she pretty? Girl number one? Or is she pretty? Girl number two. Which girl is pretty? Which girl is pretty? Okay. Nota que ahora, para hacer esta pregunta, ¿cuál muchacha es bonita? También pudiera preguntar con who. Como estás viendo las dos opciones, te puedo preguntar who is pretty. Who is pretty? Who is pretty? Girl number one or girl number two? Nota cómo se formulé la pregunta. Okay. Who is pretty? ¿Quién? Porque ahora estamos hablando de la muchacha. ¿Quién? Who sustituye a girl? Okay. Entonces, who is pretty? ¿Quién está bonita? ¿No? Y la pregunta original era which girl. ¿Cuál? Which girl. Es que, o sea, escoge. Cuando hablamos which, tienes que escoger. Es porque tienes opciones. ¿Ok? Which girl is pretty? Which girl is pretty? Let's see. What do you guys say? Which girl is pretty? Bridge number two is Long Bridge. Very good, Sandra. Sí, solo. Ok. So, which girl is pretty? Which girl is pretty? Who is pretty? Okay. Es cosa de percepción, right? Both girls are pretty. Both girls. Okay. Both girls are pretty. Both girls are pretty. Both girls are pretty. Okay. Now, puedo hacer una pregunta así. Who is a tall girl? Who's a tall girl? Who is a tall girl? Girl number one or girl number two? Who is a tall girl? Who? ¿Quién? ¿Quién es una muchacha alta? Girl number one or girl number two? Who is a tall girl? Okay. So, we don't know. Aquí no sabemos. So, girl number one is a tall girl. Okay. So, we can say girl number one is a tall girl. It's a tall girl. Okay. Now here. What is the difference? ¿Qué diferencia ven? Okay. ¿Qué diferencia ven? So, let's ask the question. Ah. Let me see here. Okay. So, we have Sally. We have Sally and we have the bald man. We have the bald man. Okay, Sally and the bald man. Sally and the bald man. Right? So, who is young? Who is young? Who is young? who is young, Sally or the bald man? Who is young? Who is young? Okay. Which person is a student? Which person is a student? Okay. And look at this one. What is her name? What is her name? What is her name? So who is young? ¿Quién es joven? Which person is a student? ¿Cuál de las, qué persona es un estudiante? What is her name? Aquí es qué o cuál persona. What is her name? ¿Cuál es su nombre? Ah, nota que aquí no es qué es su nombre, es cuál es su nombre. Y aquí podemos decir qué persona. Tomen nota. Okay, tomen nota de eso, porque which and what, ¿no? Which cuando tienes opciones. Okay, which person is a student? ¿Qué persona es un estudiante? ¿Por qué? Porque tienes opciones, por eso vas a decir which. Okay. Acá, what is her name? Nosotros decimos cuál es su nombre. No decimos qué es su nombre. Correct? Tomen nota. Tomen nota. Okay, apréndase las frases. Okay? Cuando decimos what, what is her name is cuál es su nombre. Very well. So, Sally is a student. She is young. Okay? And so, who is young? Sally is young. Sally is young. Which person is a student? Sally is a student. Sally is a student. Okay. What is her name? Her name is Sally. It's Sally. Aquí solo hablamos de Sally. Okay, what is her name? Her name is Sally. Correct? So, Sally is young. Okay, Sally's a student. And her name is Sally. Please repeat. Okay, Sally is young. Sally is a student. Her name is Sally. Excellent, excellent. So, what do you see in the picture? ¿Qué ven en estas fotos? What do you see in the pictures? Okay, what do you see? What do you see in the pictures? Okay, so we have one and two. Okay, we have one and two. What do you see in the picture? So, nota que acabo de hacer una pregunta con what. Ah, pero no la voy a escribir todavía. Porque hay algo que no les he enseñado. ¿Qué ven en la foto? Muchacho pretty. Okay, okay. Ah, very well. Dowry Gamer says, teacher, muchacho pretty, ¿cómo es la pronunciación? Ahorita les voy a decir, Sally is young, and Renee Gardina dice, hola, very well, very well. Vamos acá de nuevo, para contestarle la pregunta, ok, vamos hasta acá, hasta acá, hasta acá, ok, cuando hablamos y decimos, a girl is pretty, pero un muchacho, is a man pretty? ¿No? ¿Hay tal cosa como man pretty? No. Cuando hablamos de muchachos, se les decimos handsome. Ok, handsome. Entonces podemos decir he is a handsome. A handsome. A handsome qué? Okay. Si es un niño, a handsome child. Si es niño, a handsome boy. Si es un niño más grande, a teen. Si es adolescente, inclusive puedes decir young man. Young man, un hombre joven, o a handsome man. Very well. Entonces, son diferentes etapas de una persona, ¿no? A child es para hombre o mujer, boy, el femenino girl, teen es para hombre o mujer, okay, young man es un hombre joven, y man. Naturalmente, si dices teen, debes de saber de quién estás hablando, ¿no? Para decir pretty o handsome. So, esta palabra handsome es más apropiada para un hombre, que es como decir apuesto, guapo. Okay, he is a handsome boy. He is a handsome young man. Okay, or he's a handsome man. So, handsome. Handsome. Debí de haberla puesto cuando puse pretty, ¿verdad? Y haberles explicado esto. Muy buena pregunta. Thank you. Okay, thank you. So, now, what do you see in the picture here? Tell me what you're seeing. What are you seeing? Kevin. Kevin. Noten que les formulo preguntas de estructuras que aún no les enseño, ¿no? Pero para que después van a entender. So, picture number one. What is it? Picture number two. What is it? What is it? Let's see. Person driving. Sally's young, very good. Person driving, dice Dowdy. He sees a person driving. Okay, but do you... Okay. I see two cars, dice Sandra. Yes. So car number one, car number two. So let me ask you the question, okay? Which car? Which car is shiny? Which car is shiny? Which car is shiny? Question mark. Which car is shiny? Is car number two shiny? Is car number one shiny? Okay. Now, what is an old car? No. Tengo que preguntar con which de nuevo. Which is an old car? Which is an old car? Car number one or car number two? Okay. Very well. So we have car number one, car number two. So one is shiny. Okay, one is old. Very well. So preguntamos con which aquí, con which. Very well. So which car is shiny? Car number one is shiny, right? Car number one. Car number one is shiny. It's shiny. And then, which is an old car? Car number two. It's an old car. Car number two is an old car. Okay. Okay. Les voy a enseñar un adverbio. Un adverbio. Okay. ¿Por qué? Porque describe una acción. Y el adverbio va a ser fast. No, es un adjetivo también. It's a fast car, a slow car. Right? So fast. Los voy a hacer la pregunta. Which is a fast car? Which is a fast car? Okay. Which is a fast car? Y lo opuesto también. Which is a slow car? Which is a slow car? Fast, rápido. Slow, lento. Okay, fast and slow. So, which is a fast car? Which is a slow car? Okay. Ah. Okay. What car is made for 6 passengers? What car is made for 6 passengers? So, which is a fast car? Car number one looks like a fast car. Car number one is a fast car. A fast car. Car number two is an old car. It's probably a slow car. Car number two, a slow car. Slow car. Okay? So, which car is shy? Bueno, ya vimos eso. And por aquí creo que les puse which, no, what car. What car is a passenger? No. What car has 5 passengers? Passengers. What car has 5 passengers? So here, which is a fast car? Car number one. Car number one is a fast car. It's a fast car. Okay. Para los que están entrando, abajo en la descripción hay un archivo que puedes bajar ese archivo para que tú, al igual que yo, puedas escribir. Okay. Puedas escribir, puedas formular las preguntas y contestar las preguntas como lo estamos haciendo. Es la forma que estamos practicando con estas clases, ¿no? So, car number one is a fast car, which is a slow car. Car number two. Car number two is a slow car, right? Car number two is a slow car. So, what car has 5 passengers? What? What? ¿No? Entonces, en ocasiones podemos usar what. Okay? What? What car has 5 passengers? Okay? Car number two has 5 passengers. Car number two has 5 passengers. Okay. Car number two has 5 passengers. Car number two has 5 passengers. What car is made for 6 passengers? Okay. Well, it's actually made for five. For 5 passengers. Lo que pasa es que nosotros, si pudiéramos subir 20 personas, las subiéramos, ¿no? Very well. Let's see. Do we have anything else here? Ah, okay. Now we're going to talk about people, about persons. Okay, people, persons, right? So here we have person number one, person number two, person number three, person number four. Okay? Person number four. Who is male? Esto no les había enseñado tampoco. Who is male? Who is female? Who is female? Male and female. Okay, male. Who's male? ¿Qué es male? Male significa masculino. And female? Female significa femenino. Entonces, ¿quién de estas personas es masculina y quién es femenina? Okay. Pude haber preguntado, who's a man, who's a woman? Okay. Man y woman, se lo decimos a los adultos. Right? Todos pueden ser male or female. So, who is male? ¿Quién es masculino? Okay. Who is male? Person number one, person two, person three, or person four? Person number one is a female. Person number two is a male. Person number three is a female. Person number four is a male. Okay? So who is a male? Person one, oops, no, person two and four. Como son dos, are male. Right? Person two and four are male. Who is female? Person one and three are female. Son femeninas. Are female. Now, questions. Any questions, please ask, okay? Vayan, si tienen alguna pregunta, por favor, formulen la pregunta. Who is female? Person one and three are female. Person two and four are male, okay? One and three, female. Two and four are male. Now. So, who is tall? Who's tall? De una vez vamos a formular más preguntas con who, porque son personas. Who is short? Who is fat? Y noten cómo voy a formular esta otra pregunta. What person wears glasses? Okay. What person wears glasses? Fíjate bien. What person? ¿Qué persona? En este caso no puedo usar who. Puedo usar what o puedo usar which. Which person wears glasses? Or what person wears glasses? Okay? So let's answer. Who is tall? Tall is alto. Who is tall? Person one and two are tall. Correct? Very well. Person one and two are tall. Who is tall? Person one and two are tall. Person one and two are tall. Let me go check and see if you guys have any questions. Fast, rápido, okay. The car number one is fast. Me gusta como explico, thank you. How one person is young, okay. Who is young? This is Sandra Montoya. Who is young? Very well. So, let's go back here. Hmm. Ah, hay algo de retraso. Hay algo de retraso en la transmisión. Sí, hubo un momento que no se estaba transmitiendo bien y hay algo de retraso. No me había dado cuenta. Okay, so what person is fat? Very well. Okay. So, who is short? Well, person 3 and 4 are short. Who is short? Person 3 and 4, 3 and 4 are short, right? Who is fat? Person 3 is fat. Person 3 is fat. What person wears glasses? ¿Qué persona usa gafas? Lentes. What person wears glasses? Okay. Person number 4 wears glasses. What person? Ah, okay. Ah, vean esto. Si deseo preguntar con quién, ahora no voy a decir la palabra persona, no voy a decir qué persona, nada más quién. Who. No, vean, who wears glasses. Who wears glasses? ¿Quién? ¿Quién usa lentes? Con who. No menciono persona, pero con what voy a mencionar. Tengo que decir qué persona. No puedo decir quién persona. ¿Qué persona? Okay, so what person wears glasses? Very well. So person. Person number 4 wears glasses. Person number 4 wears glasses. Right? Outstanding. So let's look at these three. Okay. We have girl number 1, girl number 2, and girl number 3. Okay, so want to make the picture smaller. Girl number 1, girl number 2, okay, and we have girl number 3. Gonna make her smaller. Excellent. Girl number 1, girl number 2, and girl number 3. Right? 1, girl number 2, and we have a girl number 3. Very well. Girl number 1, girl number 2, and girl number 3. So, okay, girl number 1, girl number 2, girl number 3. So let's ask. Okay. So let's see here. Who is young? Who is young? Okay, who has short hair? Who has short hair? Okay, who has red hair? Okay, which girl is Japanese? Who and which, de nuevo. Oh. No, otra con what. What color? What color are grow number threes? Eyes. Number threes. Number three, eyes. And we have a question mark. So now let's answer these questions. Girl number one, girl number two, girl number three. Look at the picture. Observe carefully. Okay? Look at the pictures. Girl number one, girl number two, girl number three. So who is young? Young, joven. Girl number one, girl number two, or girl number three? So girl number, let's see, ¿quién puesto ustedes? What person is fat? Yeah, who is young? Okay. Very, thank you, Renee. Let's see here. Oops. See if I can get, can't get rid of here. So who is young? Girl number one is young. Okay, girl number one is young. Who has short hair? Who has short hair? Short hair. Look at this. Who has short hair? ¿Quién tiene pelo corto? Girl number one, short hair. Girl number two, short hair. Or girl number three, short hair. Okay, so girl number two and girl number three have short hair. Very good. Who has short hair? Now, girl number two and three, en vez de usar el has, como ahora son dos personas, entonces sería they have. Ya no es una persona. Cuando es una persona es he o she. She has, he has. Pero en este caso ahora son dos personas. Entonces en vez del has, vamos a usar el have. Girl number two and three have short hair. Okay? Girl number two and three have short hair. Very well. So who has red hair? Who has red hair? Who has red hair? ¿Quién tiene cabello rojo? So, girl number two, fíjense bien, ahora como es una sola persona, girl number two has short hair. Has short hair. Okay? So, note, acá usamos have. Y acá usamos has. Have, has. Una, she. Dos, they. Entonces usamos have. Which girl is Japanese? De nuevo, para que las vean de nuevo. Okay. En la clase de nacionalidades vimos que girl number one is Japanese. Okay, girl number one is Japanese. So let's answer. Which girl is Japanese? Girl number one is Japanese. Japanese. Okay. What color are girl number three eyes? Number three's eyes. Girl number three. What color are number three? Are girl number three eyes? What's What's the color of her eyes? Girl number three. Aquí está. Girl number three. Ok. Un poquito más grande. Creo que yo la estoy tapando, ¿verdad? La estoy tapando. Ok. Vamos a ver acá. Para no taparla. No, la sigo tapando. La vamos a bajar. Por acá. Ok. Quiero que la vean porque creo que yo la tapo. Very well. Here we go. What color are girl number three's eyes? Okay. What color are her eyes? No, no les dio oportunidad de que la vieran. Right? What's the color of her eyes? Right? Entonces vamos a usar has otra vez. Has. Okay, girl number three. Number three has brown eyes. Girl number three has brown eyes. Usamos has otra vez. Very well, porque es una. Right? So, things, cosas, cosas, things. So, bueno. Los animales también son cosas, ¿no? Solo las mascotas los tratamos como personas. What is shiny? What is shiny? What is round? ¿Qué está redondo? Okay. What is an animal? Okay. So what is shiny? ¿Qué está brilloso de esto? De estos tres. Okay, shiny. So are the shoes shiny? Yes or no? Are the shoes shiny? Are the starfish shiny? Okay. Is the apple shiny? What? Okay. One, two, three. Very well. Now I want you to tell me. Tell me. Cuando digo tell me, eso significa dime, dime, tell me. What is number one? What is number two? Two. Okay, lucky. Right. What is number two and what is number three? What is number three? What is number three? Okay. What is it? What is it? What is it? Let's see. Girl number two has short hair. Very well. What is it? What is number one? Number one. Okay, number one. A pair of shoes. Esto es algo que no les expliqué cuando vimos lo de ropa. Cosas como los pantalones, los calcetines, los zapatos, como son pares, los guantes, como vienen en pares, se les dice a pair, un par. A pair of shoes, un par de zapatos, ok, a pair of shoes. So, what is it? A pair of shoes, un par de zapatos. What is it? Okay. What is number two? Okay, number two. They. Y they también es plural de it. Entonces es para cosas y animales también, ¿no? They are. Podemos decir lo que son starfish. They're starfish. Starfish, estrellas del mar. Bueno, en inglés es. Nosotros les llamamos estrellas del mar. En inglés les dicen estrellas, peces. Peces estrella. Okay. And number three, what is it? What is number three? Okay. It is an apple. It is an apple. Okay. So now, ya sabemos qué son, right? A pair of shoes, starfish, and an apple. So, what is shiny? Shiny. ¿Se acuerdan la descripción esta? Shiny. Brilloso, right? ¿Qué es brilloso? What is shiny? So we have here the shoes are shiny. Y ahora es plural, entonces usamos el is. Shoes are shiny. What is round? Well, the apple is round. Escriban, the apple is round. The apple is round. What is an animal? ¿Qué es un animal? Well, a starfish. Is an animal. Very well, very well. Creo que ya no hay más fotos. Very well. So, hemos practicado haciendo preguntas con who, con what y con which. Okay? Y hemos visto algunos de los adjetivos que aprendimos en la clase pasada. Okay, me voy a cerrar con esta imagen. So we have a fast, shiny car. Right? And we have an old, slow car. Any questions, students? I don't know if it's your or his class. I like his class, okay? I like your, se dice your. I like your class, okay? His es de él, ya vimos eso también en otra clase. Y your es tuyo. Row number two has short hair. Very good. Thank you, Sandra, for commenting. Los invito a todos a participar en esta clase. Okay? La forma de participar es, miren, si ustedes van a la descripción del video, en la descripción vienen, inclusive cuando lo suba al... va a venir... esto, lección 11, estudiante, y aquí ustedes le hacen clic y los manda a un archivo. Ese archivo, van a ver una flechita, lo pueden bajar, ya sea a su celular o a su laptop, a su tablet, y después pueden volver a ver la clase y escribir así como estábamos escribiendo en la clase y volver a practicar, ¿no? Ese es el objetivo. Es el objetivo. So, students, If there are no more questions, si ya no hay más preguntas, we're gonna end the class. Vamos a terminar la clase, ya practicamos. Okay, let's see. Any questions? Estoy dejando porque hay un pequeño retardo ahora en la transmisión. No questions, so thank you for joining the class. Muchas gracias. And let's see the statistics for this class. Ah, no hay datos. Bueno, ¿qué más? Ni modo. Okay, so I'll see you next time. Acuérdense de dar un like, de compartir. Y acuérdense de volver a regresar y ver la clase para que capten.